Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 80th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Worldview Legion 3 and 4.
Falcon 9, go Worldview Legion.
The booster which launched this mission, B1076, then landed successfully for the 16th time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 1.
And there was that sonic boom.
Stage 2 FTS,
stage 1 landing light deploy.
Then, the following day on Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 81st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Transporter 11.
9, go Transporter 11.
The boost which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
Landing light deploy.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a few Starlink launches. The first of these, the Starlink 10-5 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 20th at 9:36 a.m. UTC or 5:36 a.m. EST. The following day, and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 9-5 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 21st at 8:47 a.m. UTC or 4:47 a.m. EST. Then finally, later in the week, and we can hopefully expect another Starlink launch. The Starlink 86 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 24th at 7:23 a.m. UTC or 3:23 a.m. EST. SpaceX posted some information about training for the new astronaut mission announced recently. It says the Fram-2 astronauts completed their first week of training for the first human spaceflight to fly over Earth's poles. Heading to Boca Chica, the launch site sheet piles continue to be installed. The 7th module for the 2nd orbital launch tower was stacked. The 8th launch tower 2 module was recently rolled out. A few days ago, somebody posted some information about the stacking progress of the orbital pad B launch tower. It says time-lapse of the sunrise stacking of module 8 atop the tower at orbital launch pad B at Starbase. With only one module left to be stacked, the stacking operation should be completed in the coming days. The orbital pad A chopstick catching arms were seen being tested. Test tank 16 was recently seen moved to Massey's test site. The B14.1 test tank was seen doing some chopstick catch testing. After testing, the B14.1 test tank was moved back to the production site. Raptor engines were seen being removed from Ship 26 inside Mega Bay 2. Ship 26 was also moved over to the rocket garden. Starship 30 was seen having its decals installed for Flight 5. The work on the replacement of Starship 31's heat shield tiles is continuing. A Starship 34 header tank was seen being moved to McGregor for some possible testing. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.